In this video, I'm going to tell you the GATE exam syllabus for Electronics and Communication Engineering and also discuss the weightage of different subjects. Hi, welcome to Vedant, EduNation, a YouTube channel that helps you to crack technical competitive exams like GATE, IES and many more, particularly in Electronics and Communication Engineering, Electrical Engineering, Instrumentation Engineering, Engineering Physics and Engineering Maths. If you are new here, please consider subscribing to our channel for problem solving episodes and also latest updates on competitive technical exams.
So the first part in the syllabus of GATE Electronics and Communication is the Aptitude Reasoning and English. And then you have the Engineering Mathematics. And then comes the actual basic subjects of Electronics and Communication, which are digital circuits, control systems, signals and systems, and network analysis. And then you have the actual core subjects of Electronics and Communication, which are electronic devices, analog circuits, communication systems, and electromagnetics. Now let's see how much marks these come in for. For the aptitude and reasoning, you have 13 to 15 marks worth of questions. For engineering mathematics, it's same again, which is 13 to 15 marks. In the basic subjects, you have 32 to 35 marks. And for the actual core subjects of electronics and communication, you have like 40 to 45 marks in the question paper. Looking at this, you might think the syllabus is quite small, but it's not so, because the engineering mathematics itself has a lot of topics. For example, the engineering mathematics includes linear algebra, calculus, differential equations, vector analysis, complex analysis, numerical methods, and probability and statistics. And also, if you look at the core subjects, for electromagnetics, you have the electromagnetic waves, transmission lines, and waveguides. In communication systems, you have analog systems and digital systems. So now let's look at the weightage in percentage of these subjects. In this chart, you can see that the core subjects appear for 40% of the question paper, and the basic subjects appear for 32% of the actual question paper. And engineering mathematics, you have 15% worth of marks, and the aptitude reasoning is usually around 13%. This percentage can slightly vary from one year to another, but in general, they remain the same. Now, let's look at the marks for each of these subjects. From engineering mathematics, you have 15 marks that appears each year. From aptitude and reasoning, you have 13 marks. In electronic devices, you get 10 marks worth of questions. Analog circuits, again the same. Communication systems, again the same. And electromagnetics, again the same. So the core subjects, which are electromagnetics, communication systems, electronic devices and analog circuits, appear 10 marks each in general in the GATE exam. Then you have the basic electronic and communication subjects, which is network analysis. They appear for 8 marks. Signals and systems, again, they appear for 8 marks. Control systems, 8 marks, and digital circuits, 8 marks. However, this weightage is not consistent. Sometimes this weightage changes. In some question papers, there are more questions from one of these subjects compared to the other. So the GATE exam syllabus is quite long and tedious, and it's very important that you start studying these subjects very early. In fact, the best way is to start studying these subjects for GATE when you go through these subjects in your engineering exams. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our channel if you are new here. I have put a link below of all these charts and information that you can download for your own reference. And also, I have an exhaustive list of the GATE exam syllabus which you have to study for. Thanks for watching, and see you later.